Welcome dear students, in your course Elect Agron 311 Agricultural Waste Management of 5th semester of your BSc Agriculture degree program, I am presenting here the 4th lecture of this course entitled Impact of Agricultural Waste on Environment. It is the lecture of Unit 1. Here in this lecture we will study the environmental issues due to the agricultural waste. These environmental issues arises due to the agricultural waste because of its improper handling. And there are a lot of agricultural waste in India which handled improperly. That's why these problems are created. So improperly they are handling as burning. So the burning of crop residue also we will study here, and the effect of residue burning on environment we will study. So some part of the waste is burnt. The another method is that some part of waste is thrown either at the side of your field or at the roadside, and it is allowed to rot in openly. It is allowed to rot in open yard. So in next slides or in next to this topic after burning, we will study that the food waste which are thrown in open yard, what happens with that food and what are the problems which is arising, or what are their impact on their environment. So these two things we will study here in this lecture today. The environmental issues due to the agricultural waste, these issues are general waste pollution, and second is the climate change. General waste pollution refers to the pollution created by the improper handling of waste. These pollutions are air pollution, water pollution, land degradation and soil contamination. And because of this improper handling and because of the pollution, these waste create or generate some greenhouse gases also: methane, nitrous oxide and carbon dioxide. These greenhouse gases is released into the atmosphere and it causes the atmospheric warming. So the climate is, it becomes a reason for the climate change. So the general warming of the climate occurs due to the improper handling of the waste. The issues of environment, the impact of agricultural waste on environment, you should be very clear that it is because of the improper handling of waste. If we do the proper handling of waste, if we go for the proper waste management, these issues still will be there, but their impact on the environment can be minimized. Because if we don't burn the food waste or our agricultural waste, so these are the environmental issues because of the improper handling of agricultural waste. This is burning the crop residue. You know what is crop residue? Crop residue is the leftover part of our crop. We grow, we do agriculture, we cultivate the land and we grow our crop. Crop is a plant and it produces biomass. The whole biomass which is produced by the crop is not of our use. So in the process of harvesting, वी हार्वेस्ट ओनली दैट पार्ट फ्रॉम द क्रॉप विच इज ऑफ आवर यूज. इफ वी टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ वीट, बिकॉज वीट वीट इज अ बेसिक स्टपल क्रॉप, राइस इज अ बेसिक स्टपल क्रॉप. इवन इफ यू कंसिडर एवरी क्रॉप, इफ यू कंसिडर बनाना, वी हार्वेस्ट ओनली फ्रूट बंच. इफ यू कंसिडर कॉटन, वी जस्ट पिक द कॉटन फाइबर्स एंड रेस्ट इज लेफ्ट ओवर द फील्ड. वीट इज अ सिंपल बेसिक क्रॉप, दैट्स वाई एवरी टाइम आई एम टेकिंग द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ वीट. प्लांट, देर इज अ होल प्लांट, द होल प्लांट इज अ बायोमास प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई द प्लांट सिस्टम इट सेल्फ, बट वी हार्वेस्ट ओनली द सीड्स बिकॉज सीड्स आर द इकोनॉमिक पार्ट एंड इज ऑफ आवर यूज. द चेफ, स्ट्रॉ एंड स्टबल्स, दीज आर द क्रॉप रेजिड्यू प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई द वीट. इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू दैट वॉट इज क्रॉप रेजिड्यू एंड वॉट इज crop residues regarded as agricultural waste. Then these wheat seeds, which is the economic part for the farmer, it is the raw material for the primary processing sector. These primary processing sectors also generate the waste, that is wheat bran, but that is not regarded as crop residue, that is the agricultural waste or the byproduct of the primary processing unit. These byproduct is known as agricultural waste. So crop residue is the part of the plant or part of the crop which is left over the field after the harvesting of the crop. There is a huge amount of crop residue produced in India and it is burnt in India. So these are the effects which are explained here due to the, these are the effects due to the crop burning. There is a global warming due to the crop burning. Emission of greenhouse gases due to the crop burning, release of soot particles causing smoke. Soot particles are the fine particles, fine solid particle but very fine. We can also say PM, particulate material. Due to the crop burning, next effect on environment or next effect on society is health hazard to human, animal and birds. Crop burning also cause loss of biodiversity. Crop burning or residue burning, it is not crop burning, it is residue burning, crop residue burning. Crop residue burning also cause loss of carbon. So carbon it should be lost or it should be retained. It is hazardous or it is a pollution causing element or it is a beneficial. Because we want to, when we grow crop, several times we used to say that the organic carbon of our soil is decreasing and it is creating problem. This carbon, if it is stored in soil, it is retained in soil, it is beneficial for crop, it supports the crop growth. But when we burn the crop residue over the soil surface, these carbon is lost into the atmosphere. When this carbon is lost into the atmosphere and these carbon gases are present in the atmosphere, then it becomes a greenhouse gases. It becomes a hazardous gas for human and animal health also. So the loss of carbon is the effect on environment due to the residue burning. If it is stored in the soil, it is beneficial. So our motto is to store the organic carbon in the soil. But the burning cause its loss from the soil. Loss of soil flora and fauna. Soil flora and fauna means several fungi, several algae, several bacteria, several molds, several yeasts. These are the microorganisms which are present in the soil. and these microorganisms which are present in the soil, they act over the carbon which is available in the soil, and these soil flora and fauna, it helps in our crop cultivation. When we burn the crop residue on soil surface, one pollution or global warming or pollution problem is created by the fire, because this fire absorbs the oxygen of the atmosphere to support the burning. This fire will absorb the oxygen and it generates carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So this is one problem, that it is absorbing oxygen. Another problem, it is generating carbon dioxide. The third problem, it is generating other greenhouse gases, and it is generating smoke, fog, and haze, and it is also generating particulate materials, that is the solid particles that is generated by the smoke of the fire. This is the one problem. Another problem, this fire on the earth surface, it heat the earth surface. So about 2 or 2.5 inch, about 5 inch top soil is heated very much. These heat up soil surface lost the carbon. So this carbon is also lost into the atmosphere. Next, this heated soil surface, it kills the soil flora and fauna, because these soil flora and fauna, I am telling you, the plants, fern or the microorganisms which are present in the soil, they need certain temperature to live. If the temperature goes beyond that, they will automatically kill. So this crop residue burning on soil surface kills our soil flora and fauna. This is one more big problem of crop residue burning. This is also associated with the loss of carbon. If any soil flora and fauna is alive in the soil which was present in the deep, it will come to the surface, because the population in deep will increase, then it will come to the area where population is less. There is no carbon, because carbon is lost because of burning. So again, there is a loss of soil flora and fauna. So this crop residue burning also deteriorates soil fertility. This crop residue burning loss the plant nutrients and biodiversity. So these are the harmful effect of crop residue burning. This crop residue burning is the first big method of improper agricultural waste handling. So here in this course, we will study the effect of residue burning on environment. Then in next lecture, we will see the effect of residue burning on soil. Because when you see this course content or syllabus, the impact of agricultural waste on environment is a one lecture, and impact of agricultural waste on soil and plant is the another lecture. So here, crop residue burning creates a lot of problem. These are the problems which is created by the crop residue burning. This one thing is, in this photograph, this photograph is taken in afternoon from Punjab. After the harvesting of rice, because rice straw is burned in the field of Punjab, it is a very promising issue. It is a very burning issue in India. In afternoon, you can see the crop is burning on the field. Fog and smoke is going towards the atmosphere, and you can see the sun. How the sun is looking like at the time of crop burning. So you can see how much smoke, fog is created by the crop burning. And this, it will create a very big, big problem of pollution, big problem of atmospheric pollution. This will affect atmosphere not only at that area where it is burned. Because of the flowing air, because of the air flow, it moves here and there, and it moves through nearby cities also, and it creates a big problem in the cities also. So this is a general scenario of India, where 500 million ton crop residue is produced. If you remember this data I have given you, according to estimated by the MNRE, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, they have estimated that about 500 million ton of crop residue is produced per annum in India. In this crop residue, about 43% crop residue is coming from rice only. So rice is a major crop which generates a lot of crop residue. So first it is rice. Rice generates about 43% of crop residue. Then secondly it is wheat. So wheat generates 21% of crop residue. So here you can see that about 64% crop residue among the whole crop residue is generated by rice and wheat only. So rice and wheat is a big problem for the environment, because they generate crop issue, that is not a problem. But these residues are in a such big amount which cannot be handled properly. If you want to handle it properly, it is a cost. And if you handle it properly, still you will get the some material that will not be very costly material, so you cannot earn so much from that. So this is very easy for the farmers to burn it. Government wants that, or society wants that, these crop residues should not be burned. So government is formulating, or government has formulated some policy to promote or to support that farmers who are not burning the crop. So the policy related matter in this crop burning issue, in further lecture you will study this point also. Next is sugarcane. 19% crop residue is generated from the sugarcane. 5% crop residue is generated from the oil seed crops, and rest crops also generate some crop residue. So about all the crop residues generated by these crops, about 25% crop residue is burnt on the farm. 25% crop residue is burnt. So crop residue, it is straw and stubble. If we don't burn it, then what is the procedure? One procedure is that we should collect it and we should go for the composting. In composting, there is a controlled decomposition. Another is, we should just plow the field, and we should incorporate these crop residue in the soil and allow it to rot, or allow it to decompose in the soil. It will also take time. It has also a cost, because we should need to put some urea or some nitrogen in the field, which is a cost only, because we should irrigate the field and then allow it to burn, allow it to decompose in the soil. So it is being done, but it is not, don't think that people doesn't go for that and it is very easy to burn. No, people go for that also, but there are more the farmers, some farmers who are not aware and who are not in a position or in mood to avail such time. They are in hurry to sow next crop, So they go for the burning. This is the reason I'm showing this data. This is the reason that I'm showing the data that 25% crop residue is burnt, not all. So even next thing, which crop residue is burnt? Here this is the reason I told you that one reason that these are the crop which contributes larger amount in crop residue. Other crops like banana or other crops like our spices, vegetables, they generate crop residue in lesser amount. Because it is in larger amount, so burning is the easy solution. Next thing, if you want to burn the crop residue from vegetables, you cannot burn. The advantage or the feature of the crop residue produced from rice and wheat, sugarcane and oilseed. The feature of this crop residue is that it is totally dry residue. So for the burning of crop residue, the dry residue is very easy to burn. So about 25% residue is burnt in India. Now come to the effect of burning on environment. When crop residue is burned, what are the effects? What are their harmful effect on environment? So they emit greenhouse gases and contribute in global warming. You know, I told you, when there is a fire, it absorbs the oxygen from the atmosphere. So this is one problem. Another, it generates carbon dioxide. It takes carbon from the soil surface also. And carbon dioxide, and carbon is also present in the residue. So it takes oxygen from the atmosphere. Carbon is present in crop residue. I told you the nature of crop residue is cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin. Cellulose and hemicellulose are carbohydrate. Carbohydrate means compound rich in carbon. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. It is known as carbohydrate. So carbon which is present in the residue, that is converted into the carbon dioxide by absorbing the atmospheric oxygen. And carbon which is present in the soil surface, it is lost because of the heat, and it is also added with the oxygen absorbed by the fire from the atmosphere and converted into the carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide is greenhouse gas which contributes in global warming. It increases the PM2.5 and cause health hazard also. So in air pollution, this crop residue burning contributes a lot in air pollution. How it contributes? By generating or by releasing carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide is also released from the burning process. It also releases ammonia, it also releases nitrous oxide, it also releases non-methane hydrogen, it also releases volatile organic compounds, and it also releases PM2.5. Now you are thinking that what is PM2.5? PM means particulate material. It means it is a material which is in form of particles. That's why, so it is a solid material, because it is a particle. It is a material of solid nature which is in form of particle. This is known as PM 2.5. 2.5 it is the size of that material. PM 2.5 means particulate material lesser than 2.5 micron size is known as PM 2.5. All the material which is lesser than lesser than 2.5 micron is known as PM 2.5. So PM 2.5 measurement is the criteria of environmental pollution. So by the burning of crop residue, these particulate material whose diameter is lesser than 2.5 micron, these material is spread in the atmosphere. So this is a big problem which is created by the crop residue burning. Crop residue burning contributes 20% of India's carbon emission. You see, carbon emission, as I told you, carbon presence of organic carbon or presence of carbon in soil is beneficial because it helps to develop soil microflora and fauna, and it helps in the crop production. But when this carbon is lost into the atmosphere, it is a problem. It creates atmospheric pollution. So this carbon emission is checked by the these environmental bodies, and if you reduce your carbon emission, then carbon credit is given to you. This is a international agency which is monitoring it. So whatever the carbon is emitted in India, most of the time we blame that industries are emitting carbon. Yes, there is, it is not wrong. Industries are emitting carbon, our vehicles are emitting carbon. So there are so many sources which are emitting or generating carbon and contributing carbon emission to the atmosphere. Agriculture also contributes 20% share in that emission, and that is because of this crop residue burning. And that is because of crop residue burning, not because of crop growth. Because when we do agriculture, we grow crop, we absorb the carbon from the atmosphere. Because our plants, green plants which are growing in our process of agriculture, these green plants absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release oxygen to the environment. So we are helping the society, we agriculturists are helping the society by growing crops in the purification of atmosphere also. But we spoil all our good work by emitting 20% carbon, and crop residue burning is the major cause of carbon emission in the atmosphere. You can also see that how much carbon dioxide is emitted in the atmosphere. See, 500 million is the agricultural waste. These are the agricultural waste: 43%, 21% from rice and wheat, and from sugar cane also, and about 25% of this is burnt. So you can see, you can imagine that how large quantity of waste is burnt in India. This is a ratio that burning of 1 kg crop residue add 1.5 kg carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So by this ratio, you can just imagine that how large quantity of carbon dioxide crop residue is burning, is emitting into the atmosphere. So this is a harmful effect of agricultural waste or improper handling of agricultural waste to the atmosphere. So it creates environmental pollution. It harms our environment. Secondly, it harms our health. So this residue burning is harmful for our health. So how it is harmful for our health? One thing, it reduces oxygen level in atmosphere, and it increases the carbon dioxide level in the atmosphere. How they done it, I have explained. It also releases smog into the atmosphere. So this smog, the picture graph which you are seeing here, this is from Delhi. In November, when this crop residue was burnt in Punjab and Haryana, in western part of Uttar Pradesh. And this picture graph is from Delhi because of airflow, this fog and haze comes to Delhi. And lot of vehicle is daily is also emitting this, is also polluting the environment. So when the crop residue burning and pollution is added in the presence atmosphere pollution of Delhi, then the problem becomes a very big. So smoke causes irritation in eyes and nose. So what is smoke? This is a, because when we generate, we burn the crop residue, smoke is generated. Smoke matlab dhua, smoke, smoke mare dhua. This is smoke, smog. This smoke in atmosphere, if it is dense, in dense form, it creates fog in the atmosphere. This smoke from the burning, this smoke when it spread to the side by area because of the airflow, and its density is less, it is haze. Smog is the another form of pollution, and it is dangerous. Smog is dangerous. These smoke or fog, which is created because of the crop burning, this smoke combines with the moisture present in the atmosphere, that is atmospheric humidity. Atmospheric humidity means the water molecules present in the air in form of vapor. When that water molecule in form of vapor combines with the smoke, so it has got a surface to rest. So this water molecule and smoke particles, it is bind together and a smoke is created. And this smoke is a very hazardous for the human health, so it creates irritation in our eyes and nose. And because of this burning, PM 2.5 also increased in the atmosphere, and it creates the health problem. So because of this smoke and PM 2.5, people used to wear a mask in Delhi at that time when pollution is more. Nowadays, because of corona, in all the country, government is insisting, or health worker or doctors are insisting, that everybody should wear a mask. Here, to save us from the corona, which mask we should wear? So doctors are telling that it is 3-layered cloth mask you should wear. But nowadays, N95 mask is very popular. So doctor should wear N95 mask, and if you want to make your more safe, rather than covering your mouth with 3-layer cloth, you should wear N95 mask. Nowadays this N95 mask is very popular because of corona also. So I am leaving a question for you here. What is the meaning of N95? This is N95 is a type of mask. So N95 mask means, in a mask, what is the meaning of N95? I am leaving this question for you. You think over it, you read it, and we will discuss it in our interaction session and webinar. So this is one part of improper handling. This is, that is, crop residue burning and its harmful impact on the environment. Next part is dumping of agricultural waste in open yard. When we have the option to burn, why we dump it? Because there are certain agricultural waste which are wet in nature. The agricultural waste which are dry in nature, we can burn very easily. In the photograph you are seeing the fruit waste, vegetable wastes. You cannot burn these wastes till you dry it completely. And for the drying, you should spread it over the ground, you should turn it time to time. Otherwise, lot of moisture is already present in this waste. even if you go for the drying and you will not dry it properly, or you will not, or you will not follow the drying process, either you can go for the machine drying again it is a costly, and if you will not go for the proper drying, means spread it over the ground. When you spread it over the ground, sun and air will be in the contact of upper surface only, but lot of moisture will be present in lower surface, and the rotting starts from lower surface. So if you want proper drying, you will turn it again and again. That is also a big problem farmer doesn't want to do. This is a wet waste, farmer cannot burn it. So for the farmer, it is very easy to dump it in open yard. Open yard means either side of the field or roadside. Most of the time it is dumped at the roadside. This is again a big problem, because farmer, they doesn't think there about their social responsibility. If farmer should want to dump their waste which is collected from the field, these are the wet waste, farmer should make a pit and dump it into the pit and then cover the pit. But farmers are not aware about their social responsibility, and even for the saving their cost, they just throw it or dump it at roadside. Then it creates a problem. So these are the wet waste, first thing. These are not easy to burn. The another thing, when it is dumped in open yard, it is the several kind of products and material is mixed in this waste. If it is tomato fruits, the waste of tomato fruits only, then their handling process is different. If tomato and potato is mixed, handling process is different. If tomato is mixed with some leaves and stems, some other fruits like coconut or some mango stone, everything is collected from the field. So several mixed material, its decomposition will be a difficult process. So it, because of mixed nature of this waste, its decomposition is difficult. And because of mixed nature, lot of microorganisms developed in this waste, and they start decomposing it. So they start rotting it. That's why I am saying every time that, see, if you will throw it at any yard, it will decompose automatically. When it is decomposed, it will be a manure. But if it is uncontrolled decomposition, or it is mix of the material, it is decomposing without any control, and so it spreads some diseases also, it spreads some hazardous gases also. So what is the, that's why this decomposition should be at proper place and proper area. If you do decomposition, whether aerobic or anaerobic, still these gas emission problem will be there. But when you do it in a proper way, then you can definitely do it not at roadside or not at the side of your village. You will do it somewhere far from your village, in the field, in a pit. And when you will do it in a pit, then this, the release of harmful gases will be less. You can make two or three pits. Tomato will be dumped in one pit. Potato will be dumped in one pit, banana peel or mango peel will be dumped in another pit, and decomposition can be controlled. So this is a improper handling, that the waste is dumped in open yard at roadside. So rotting starts. So this rotting is of both type, aerobic and anaerobic. Both rotting occurs simultaneously in open yard dumping waste. This anaerobic rotting, it generates carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and methane. Aerobic rotting generates carbon dioxide and ammonia. Again, I am leaving a question for you. Whenever you pass, if you are walking or you are going through the road and waste are dumped at the side, when you pass from that side, you just close your nose with your handkerchief. Why you close your nose? because of bad odor. So when these wastes are dumped somewhere, even if there may be the animal waste also, there may be the animal waste also. So if animal waste is there, it creates a very bad smell, bad odor. That's why you close your nose, mouth and nose with handkerchief or with cotton. So I am leaving a question for you. Think over it, read it. We will discuss it in our interaction session. What is the reason that this rotting bio waste creates a lot of bad smell or lot of bad odor? This is a question for you. One more thing I want to add here. Because it is open yard rotting, so many rats, so many insects, house flies, birds, they will also visit this site. And lot of microorganisms which are generated or which are proliferating in this waste for the fast rotting of the waste, some microorganisms are hazardous for our health, for human and animal health. So this will also create one thing, the environmental impact is that it emits greenhouse gases and there is a global warming, it causes global warming. Next is it creates bad smell. Third, that it also creates the health hazard for the villagers. So health hazard is not because bacteria are proliferating in this waste. This health hazard is because of the vectors. The bacteria and fungi, basically bacteria which are proliferating in this waste, they are the disease causing bacteria for the human. But several rats, insects, house flies, birds, they visit this site, then they visit to our village and our house. So they carry the disease to the house and disease spread problem will be more for the area where this open yard dumping is done. This is another problem, that is health problem because of the open yard dumping. So what we have learnt in this lecture, we got the awareness about the problem created by the waste if we don't handle it properly. So the importance of proper waste handling is now will be very clear to you people. For the further reading, you can go through this article. There are two articles I am presenting. That is, one is crop residue burning in India, policy changes and potential solutions. So when I will tell you this, what is the policy regarding crop residue burning, government policy, or what is the government support for those farmers who are not willing to burn their crop, so that government policy I will teach you in this course, also in further lecture. So this will be the reference for that also. And this will be the reference for, here this is the reference for the problems or the impact of crop residue burning on environment. So the article is published in International Journal of Environmental Research Public Health in March 2019, in volume 16 number 5, at page number 382. So you can go through this article also. One article is written by Karamveer Lathar in 2012. This article was published in newspaper Jagran. In Jagran you can read this article, Paryavaran ke liye ghatak hai puwal jalana. Thank you very much.